Blunder attack! What is up, the world? Oh, it's a Pope Missile. It's your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here. Hanging out today, doing stuff and things. Playing some Ark Survival Evolved, peeps. Hope you guys are having a good day. 3052. I'm having a really good day. I'm out on Thruster, and BTC just said that there's an Alpha Carno in this area, and I want to test whether or not Thruster can kill it. It is a level something something 20. So it's not a super high level one. And he said it was at 3052. So we're heading there now. We're actually at 3050. So I don't know if 3052 would be in Softus's base. I feel like perhaps he has the coordinates mixed up. But we're going to try to find it. And we're going to try to kill it. So yeah, hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a pretty good day. It is in the evening times for me, which is weird because for you guys, it's not in the evening times. You want to go? You just got blenderized. It's in the evening times for me, so we're a little bit more relaxed. I did my workout today. I'm getting rid of my YouTube body. It's gonna be amazing. And I can't find this Alpha Carno. We'll find it, though, and we're going to try to kill it. And it's going to be the most amazing thing that ever happened. Oh, I want to tell you guys. Oh, there it is. There it is. I want to tell you guys, thank you guys so much for all your likes and support and kind comments and stuff and things like that on all the videos. Your continued support means a lot to me, and I really do appreciate it. If you guys like this video, don't forget to smash the like button if you haven't already. Don't forget to hit subscribe for more daily stuff and things. We're going to come back here. Are you really going to peeve with me? Are you going to peeve with me? That words. All right, let's do this. First, we're going to blenderize this guy. Get blenderized, homie. Epic battle. Epic battle. We're blenderizing him. Oh, that Parasaur is running right into the fray. Also, the coloring on this guy is amazing. Parasaur ate the dust. Yeah, I'm having the words are a little bit words today. So it looks like it might take a minute. These guys have a lot of hit points. So, and I'm going to need to rest for stamina a couple of times. But once we get him down, I'm hoping we'll get him down. If anything exciting happens, if we die or something like that, I'll bring you guys back. We'll be our bees, peeps. And we're back! We did it, peeps! We killed it! And it wasn't that difficult, and we didn't even take that much damage. Get blenderized! You guys, we killed him, man. Nail the day stick can't be stopped! Did we get anything amazing? Primitive stone pick! So awesome! Primitive slingshot, amazing! No, it looks like that we got a lot of prime meat, which we don't need. We've got tons and tons, so that's not a big deal. But, and we got a Rex Boneskin helmet, but no really good items, which is kind of a pain in the butt, but that's fine. It happens, you know, it's totally fine. We actually only lost around 1,500 hit points, 1,600 hit points. I didn't have to stop and heal at all. So pretty unbelievable. Let's see, we got one level. We got two levels out of that, so now we're 222 on Thruster. And he's doing great. So, you know, kind of amazing. I just want to make sure that you guys know. I just killed... Is that a wild T-Rex? Are there wild T-Rexes here? Or is he on Wander? But I just wanted to say, I think they're on Wander. No, that is a wild Rex. These guys' base is so dangerous. They have this whole area up here where they just get spawns and things that fall down. This is Softus's base. They get spawns and things just fall into their base all the time. But I wanted to tell you guys, I just wanted to say... We just killed an Alpha Carno with a Pteranodon. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, previously unknown the powers of the Pteranodon. Where the heck am I? Okay, I have an idea. But pretty amazing stuff and things. So yeah, hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. We got some stuff and things planned. I'm going to do a little bit of building stuff, but something a little bit different. The other day we were talking about we need to get organized. Our dinosaur, we have like dinosaur issues. So I think we're going to try to get a little bit organized. And I have a couple cool ideas of how we're going to do it. We got to gather up some materials and probably drop some weight in the form of meat. And yeah, so I'm going to grab some stuff and things. I'm going to build some
I think what we're going to do this time or with this build is like we have before. We're going to build out a thatch probably to start with just to kind of get it going. And then we will convert it over to metal as we get more metal. Level 92 Carno. No. And then so, yeah, that's what we're going to do today. I'm excited about it because I love getting organized and organization is key. It's one of my mottos, peeps. But yeah. All right. I'll be down here and then I'll be BRBs. And we're back. Getting some building supplies together, but the moment of truth is here, peeps. The moment of truth is so here. This is an Alpha T-Rex. It is a level 12. Okay, so nothing major, but we've got to try. Now, we're a little bit low on HPs right now, so we're going to go ahead and heal up just so that we have a little bit to coming in here. But then it's going to be time to take this guy out on our new battle Pteranodon. I'm really excited about this whole thing, and I think it's really cool. I never thought these guys could ever be at a point where they would be this powerful, and it's so, I don't know, it's just neat for me. It's like fish out of water type deal, so I'm kind of excited about it. All right, so I feel like we got enough HPs. Let's get to this, baby. Are you already bloody? I certainly hope so. Blunder attack! And we're back! And this just got real, peeps. I had to switch guys. Like, it was really tough. It was really tough and really scary. We were really, really close to losing Thruster. And so, and I just didn't want to. I didn't want to risk it at all. Oh my gosh, there's another Alpha? It's like the Alphas everywhere, man. What the crap is happening? There's an Alpha in Softus's base now? I can't even believe it. But Thruster is like really, 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 really hurt. He got down to, he's about 1,700 hit points. It was pretty rough. So, I can't even believe it, man. Alright, so we got levels on Ouncey, though, which is sweet. So, what are we going to pump on him? I guess melee damage. I'm going to head over to Softus's base and help out with that guy as well. Because I don't think they're online, or I'm not sure. So, I'm going to do that, and I'll be RBs. And we're back under cover of night. So much has changed since we have last spoken. The Alpha at Softus's base was taken care of preemptively before I ever arrived. And then I started to think about these dino pens. And then I started to think about this area over here. And what I thought about it was, well, this is basically how it went. I said to myself, self, this would be a great place for there to be some dinos all in a long line like this. But, oh, egg! No, not ride. Egg. So then I said to myself, self, it doesn't make any sense to put our flying birds down here on the ground. It would make sense to put our flying birds up on top of the building. That's where the flying birds should go. And then I said to myself, but this is a super dangerous spot. Now, although, oh, we may be heavy. Why are we heavy? Egg? Oh, and 100 metal. So I said to myself, up here would be a great spot, except, now there normally aren't RGs that come up here, but if I do park my birds up here, and some wild RGs do come up here, it's just going to be a big disaster. Oh, yes, also I have outlined everything in fences and railings, except for the one place where I can't place one, which I'm still trying to wrap my mind around why exactly that doesn't work. It says that there's no support there, but obviously there is a support, and I have looked all the way down bottom here, and I have actually replaced the bottom support, and it still gives me that message, but whatever. So anyway, the point being is that we're going to need some sort of automated defenses. And then I thought we could do plant species X turrets. But then I thought the base is made of metal. We need metal turrets. And they're really expensive. And I've just spent all my metal yesterday. Pardon me. Earlier today. This is when we recorded yesterday's episode. Making the base made all entirely of metal. So I decided that I would go to the Mountain Forge and make more metal. And I have done that. Behold. Metal. So I need to actually place this RG egg back. And then the other thing that I did was I didn't want to have to learn all the engrams for the auto turret. So I started to do a little bit of hunting to find out if there was a auto turret blueprint around somewhere. Blueprint? Blueprint. Blueprint. I like that word though, blueprint. And there was one. And who had it? Blame the controller had it. So, then I came up to my Bronto here, named Slow Mobility, and I turned on my fabricator, which you can hear right here, And I started to take a look at the recipe. We'll just turn it off because we're going to be talking. So we need 140 metal ingots. Nailed it. We need cementing paste. Oh, no. Oh, no. I think we've run chink in the armor, Ted. So anyway, let's just take a look at this again. So 70 electronics per, and I've got 300. 7, 14, 21, 20. So I can build 4 turrets. And then we need 20 polymer, of which we've got a bunch, 360, so we can build a huge amount. 140 metal ingots per, and you saw on Pugly we've got a bunch there, but we need, basically, I want to build 4 of these. We need 200 more cementing paste, of which there is none. And so, I think, is that a T-Rex tail? I think it was a T-Rex tail. I think that we are out of cementing paste. Let's go check on hardware. Well, I know, let me see, in here I'm pretty sure we're out. Yep, nothing there. In here, extra cementing paste. Yes, nailed it. HD can't be stopped. I just have to pat myself on the back and say that I'm pretty awesome for thinking ahead and making stuff in mass constantly. So we have the cementing paste that we need. So now, as long as we put the metal inside the slow mobility, we should be able to make 4 of these auto turrets right now. I'm also kind of excited about the experience that we possibly can gain from this because we are, by the way, level 88 now, and we need a lot of XPs to get to the next level. So, is that 4? Probably will be enough. So, let's go ahead and grab all this stuff. Can we pick all of you up at the same time? We'll allow it. Nailed it, Ace to KB stopped. And then we'll squirt all of it inside of here. Nailed it, Ace to KB stopped. Then we'll turn it on. Can we make 4? 5! That, now you're just being crazy. Still 5. Shift T. Still 5. What the crap? Now 4. All right. Now we can craft all 4 of these guys. Here's our level 88. 226. 227 is basically where we're at. 227. 50. What would that be? Wait. 800. This will be easier to see. 290. Yeah, 290 experience per. So that's not bad. And we got our 4 auto turrets. We nailed it, Ace that can't be stopped. Now, this brings up a couple other issues that we've got to think about. We've also got to get a Jenny going. Now, are those inside of here? They are. Nailed it, Ace that can't be stopped. Building the Jenny. We've got to get some electrical wiring done for this, and that's going to be a little bit tricky. Now, I have a bunch of wiring done already, but it's always been my goal to have everything in the base wired off a single generator. Now, where that generator is most likely not down here on the bottom. This would be kind of... I'm really burdened. I have a bunch of metal on me. I always envisioned that the Jenny would be up on the top. So, we'll actually just take Ouncy up here. We will go up Ouncy's butt and come up inside of here. So, the difficult part of doing this is the wiring. I want the wiring to be well done, so to speak. And so, I'm trying to just kind of have a think about how that would work. And the way I'm thinking is we would do it, like, right over here. So, we would put down our Jenny, like, right here. Oh, wait. Well, we could do like this. I'm also getting a little bit of some really kind of clickety lag right now. I'm trying to see what's going on. Everything seems to be running normally. So I'm not sure exactly what's going on with that. All right. So, but down here, we'll take a look at this. Whoa. Why? Ouncy, why are you so bad at flying right now? Could you please be good at flying? So the way that this works is I do believe we can get one... I'll show you guys. We can get one vertical wire. So if we look up wire. Wait, it's not under wire? What do you look like? Cable. A vertical cable will attach to this portion of the Jenny. You see right there? And then also the horizontal. We can look up cable now. The horizontal cable, I do believe, will fit on either side. So you can see we can do it right here. And then we've done one already on the other side that's underneath here. So either way, there would be fine. And so that the point of this being is that I want to run wire from down here where the Jenny is all the way up to the top where we're going to have some turrets. But then I want to be able to run it. I guess I don't know how we're going to do that. I want to be able to run it all the way over to the elevator as well and kind of wire that in the same place. So this is a little bit tricky. I'm a little bit confused as to which would be the best way to accomplish this goal. I'll have to think about it, but that's what I'm going to work on next, guys, so we can get these turrets going. Also, we need a lot of gunpowder because we're going to need to make a lot of bullets for these things too. But I'm psyched. It's going to be so cool to have the turrets doing our defense for us. And I already did make up a bunch of gunpowder, I do believe. Again, thinking ahead. Nailed it. Oh, wait, not yet. Here we go. Bam, 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 bam. Nailed it. It can't be stopped. Okay, so one other piece of this is we need, I do believe, advanced rifle bullets. That's the advanced sniper bullet. That's the advanced bullet. If I'm not mistaken, this is the bullet that we're going to need in order to... Medium caliber modern bullet primarily used with fabricated rifles. Well, I'll check it out. I'll make sure this is the bullet that we're going to need, but that's all the stuff and things that I've been thinking about. I'm really excited to get these turrets online because they're pretty cool. They're a little expensive, but they're going to match the base way better than the Plant Species X stuff and things. So, all right, peeps, I'll be our bees. And we're back, and I have so much to show you guys. And you just see, look, you can see something, there's wires. There's wires. Some wires are still wires, but there's wires. Check this out. So it is the advanced rifle bullet. I was pretty sure it was the advanced rifle bullet, but I didn't know for sure, so I wanted to check. And I don't want to ride you all, not even a little bit. What I would love is to fall on the ground here. Thank you. And if I could have the medal. Thank you so much for the medal. Thank you. Yes, we've made it. Oh, wait, no, you go back in there and then over here. Okay, now we can come up inside of here. I've learned the correct ingot. Wait, what? Is it made in a fabricator? Please don't tell me that that's the case. Crap, it's made in a fabricator and I brought all this stuff over here. Okay, so we can go back. Well, I'll do it later. So I will show you what I have done here though. So up over here, I have placed the new Jenny and two refrigerators quite nicely and quite straight in fact. Now, the weird thing about this Jenny's placement is that I couldn't place it from over here, and I couldn't place it from outside the railing area, so I had to place it backwards from this angle and then spin it. And then it was weird. I couldn't quite see, and I was hoping that I would get it completely straight, and I didn't quite, but it did come out not terrible. So check it out. Back here, we've got a cross piece, and this runs. There's our box to power our fridges. And then this runs. You can see it's a little off, but over that length, pretty good. Not bad. So pretty straight. Pretty close. So, and then this goes underneath here and comes down over here and has a cross piece there and then comes down over here and comes down inside of there. And that's powering, I do believe, there is a box right there. You can barely see it. It's inside the elevator track and that's powering our elevator. I got to get my Quetzal over here so I can pull the rest of those down. And if I'm not mistaken, when the elevators first came out, you had to power each individual section, but I do believe they've changed that. So now that one box should power everything because I've checked and the elevator is powered. I broke down the Jenny and all the stuff and things right over here. So that has been taken care of as well. Now the next portion of our adventure is to just take our metal, which now we've got to bring back over to our fabricator and start making our advanced rifle bullets. Now, what do we need to make advanced rifle bullets? I'm guessing gunpowder and metal. Other than that, I'm not exactly sure yet. Let's grab all this gunpowder and let's go ahead and fly over and take a look at it real quick and see what it is that we need. Now, the other thing I was looking at too was the range on these turrets. And Hold on. Okay, I have it up in front of me. So there's low, medium, and high range. And the high range is 81 meters, which is approximately 27 foundations. That's a really long way. That's like a really, really long way. So, oh, it's just metal ingots and gunpowder. Okay. So we can bam, 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 bam. And now we can see our advanced rifle bullets. We can turn this bad boy on. We can make 90 already. Nailed it, ace decay stuff. So we're going to have to keep a lot of these bullets on hand. So more metal. We're like the gods of metal. And I'm betting that we're out of gunpowder, so we can make some more of that. But we got 90 bullets over here getting made up. There's just a couple left. And so the next portion would be the placement of our turrets. So I have all the turrets back up inside of there. You know what? I'm going to check really quickly. I'll just leave that bad boy running. It uses, what, one gas every 15 minutes? It should be fine. Let's check and see if we've got any more. Whoa. Did I make more gunpowder? Look how smart I am! I did make a little bit more gunpowder. And I think I am running low on charcoal, which I've made more of! Right there, nail the days that can't be stopped. So we will squirt all that inside of there, craft, and then we'll go over and make some more bullets here in a minute. Low range of the turret is 6.7 foundations, which I think is going to be fine for this application. Now, there's only three modes we can choose here for targeting, which I really think there needs to be a fourth mode. There's all targets, so it's players, tame creatures, and wild creatures. There's players and tame creatures only, and only players. And I really, really, really wish that there was a only wild creatures option, but I guess it doesn't really matter, because when it says tamed creatures, it's not going to attack my tamed creatures. It's only going to attack tamed creatures and players. Like, all targets would be players, target tamed creatures, and wild creatures, and it's only going to attack those from other tribes, of which there are none on the server at this point in time. And so it should be safe to use that as our targeting method. All right, so now we're going to grab two of our auto turrets, and we're going to pop up to the top here. This is where our guys are going to be. And I'm thinking, oh my gosh, this is like the moment of truth. Oh, baby, right here on top of this thing. Oh, does that look good? Oh, wait, I can't really see. Hold on, let's go like this. This way we can kind of get a better idea. Oh, yeah, that's great. Nailed it, ace, that can't be stopped. It's in. Unpowered? There's a box underneath you. Do you need to be turned on? Set pin code change, access inventory. Why are you unpowered? I do believe I put a power box underneath here. Did I not? I did not. That would probably be a reason why it's not powered. Okay, so let's do that then. That'll be a pretty easy fix. There's a sad pteranodon carcass in the new base. We're going to have to scrub. All right, so there we can get this guy. Squirt that like that. Come up over here. Squirt it out. Breaks. Nailed it, ace the cave stopped, I bet. And then over here. Can we get an angle on that bad boy? We'll have to come back around for another pass. Nailed it, ace the cave stopped. Now, are you powered? Are you a powered turret? Powered. Oh, baby. It's good to go, man. So we got our turret over here, and then I think we're going to squirt another one down over into this early direction like so. This will be a really good spot as well. So let's go like this. Let's get it kind of lined up. I like that. Let's go like this. And then we'll put it right in the center like so. Nailed it. Aced it. Can't be stopped. That's like the best thing ever. I just want to do that over and over. Shoot it. Shoot that thing. Oh, you don't have any bullets, do you? Oh, sad. Are you excited? We should name them. Your name will be Bruce, and your name will be Jim. Jim and Bruce the turrets. Hold on, Jim. I mean, Bruce. There you go. All right. We've got our turrets. Up a little higher with the turrets probably wouldn't be bad either. But, yeah, for nowsies, that'll be what we do. All right. So we've made more bullet powder. You know, I never understood why they call it gunpowder, because you don't make guns with it. Let's go ahead. Yep, that's right. Wisdom nugget. So over here, let's grab the rest of this gunpowder out. And we have a huge amount of metal. And we will go back and bring our bullets that we've made up to our turrets and have some fun with them. I'm pretty sure we played with these, me and Zul'jin, on the last server. And it was a lot of bullets that these guys went through. So, can you make me some more bullets, please? 60! All right, I'll take it. Let's take those bullets. And now, at least, we'll be a lot... I feel a little bit safer about bringing dinos up top there now. So, I do believe low targeting would be best. The low distance. So that's probably what we'll go with. So let's take a look here. Let's just squirt all these bullets in here. All right, you're locked and loaded, homie. What do we got going on here? Targeting players or tame creatures only. So we want to change range to high. Change target to only players. Change warning to 2 second warning. No, we don't want to. 4 second warning. No. No warning. No warning. Only players. All targets. Are you a target yet? Come over here. Why is there a Quetzal on over by Brian's house? All right, so I thought that these guys would be close enough that we would see some hot targeting action, but it looks like that they're not. I have the target range to high. That doesn't look like... It looks like it's less than 27 foundations away. All right, but anyway, 6 or a half dozen. We won't see it work right now. We could go try to get it to work. Let's see here. Let's go Gamma 4. Let's fly right down here. There's gotta be something we can pick up. Is there a scorpion? Hello, little scorpion. All right, buddy. Let's see this happen. Oh my god, it takes so many bullets. It took like, how many bullets were in there? It was like 90 something, right? It worked, but it took like 90 something bullets. You'd think it would be like, brrr. So that was like 11 bullets that it took to kill that thing. But you know what? You can't put a price on safety. So I'm glad we got it done. All right, that's cool. So I'm really much happier about putting our birds up here now, except that I don't have a ladder up, but we can fix that problem too. All right, guys. A couple other things I'm going to do, and I'll BRBs. And we're back! Excuse me. And we've done the peeps. We've done the thing. We have all of our guys here up on top where I think we should have them, and I think this is a great spot to keep them as long as they're safe. With these auto turrets, hopefully, should be pretty safe. And like I said, nothing really ever comes around here as far as anything that's aggressive. And I also just really quickly went down here and built a ladder that comes down into the other area. We got all our new wiring done. We've got our new place up here. So basically, we're kind of moving the base from down there to up here, just slowly but surely. And we've got a lot of it done today. We got a lot of stuff and things done. I got to go get more metal because we got to have all sorts of other metal stuff and things going on. I think tomorrow we might go on an adventure. Some sort of an adventure away from the building stuff. We've got a lot done in a little amount of time, so I think this is pretty cool. Also, I want to show you guys. Pardon me, let me game it down for you. You know, one of the greatest things about these turrets is that you can just pick them up. And I was thinking that we might raise them up a little bit. So I don't know. Or at the very least, oh, you know what would be really cool? We don't even need to raise them up. I have a really neat idea. Actually, we're not going to be gone. Hold on, BRBs, peeps. And we're back. And I think that really just sets it off. I just put some railings. I took the railings out from the edges there, and I put railings on the inside like this. Oh, you tracking something, big guy? Oh, he's tracking it. Oh, I think it's like line of sight. You couldn't quite see it through the floor there. That was so cool looking. All right, but any hoozle peeps. That's going to be it for today. I hope you had fun hanging out. I know I did. If you guys liked the video, please don't forget to hit the like button. Feel free to share it, favorite it, as you